go. Let's start with our little twisting. And because it's Music and Movement Friday, we're going to flow through the warm-up just a little bit quicker than normal. So we can get to some fun exercises. I'm going to throw in a little yoga today. All right, let's go to the head and neck. Ear to shoulder, taking it side to side, feeling that nice little stretch. Oh yeah. And again, while we're here, we're just trying to create that space between our vertebrae and get a little taller as we go. Let's go forward and back. And as we're going forward and back, you can even add a little rotation. Play with different angles. And then just turn it into a little rocking and rolling. Oh yeah. Nice. Roll into those shoulders. Nice and smooth. Other direction. And let's shuffle them one at a time. Bring them up together, hug the neck with a big inhale and then release. Let's do it again. Inhale up and hold. Exhale, release. One more time. Little shimmy, and then round out. Roll yourself up, open up to the sky. Oh yeah, back and forth. Getting that nice flexion and extension of the upper spine. Back to center, take it side to side. Bring our attention to our core a little bit. Let's have a light draw in here. And reach with the arm. And forward and back. To engage strong at those end ranges, drawing in that deep transverse abdominis is what it's called. Let's try different angles, a little rotation with it. And little circles. Other direction. Right into the hips, side to side. And forward and back. Big circles. Oh yeah, switch directions. And shake out those hips. Good, bring the feet and knees together. Spread the toes, rock side to side. Center yourself, bring it up, squeeze those quadriceps. Feel the kneecaps draw in and then drop down. Each time maybe going a little bit deeper. Really warming up those legs, getting them ready to move. Let's add a little circle for that lateral and rotational stability for the knees. Other direction. Engage the core, round out the back, and slowly roll yourself up one vertebra at a time. Make fists, step the feet apart, rock the ankle, and then slow roll the wrist. You're trying to create some energy in the forearms. Try to warm them up, get them ready. Do the other ankle and then spread the fingers wide and slow roll the wrists again. Good, now just relax. Shake them out. Shake out the wrists and ankles. Good, step wide, take it side to side. Let's ground those feet. Be wide enough to where you feel a little stretch in the inner thigh, just a light one. And then as you straighten the leg, lift that arch. So we strengthen this arches in our foot. We're just going through each of the areas and joints and whatever their little issues might be, we're trying to counter those, because people tend to, their toes tend to be stuck together, their arches tend to collapse, the knees tend to be weak laterally. So each little warm-up exercise we're doing is kind of helping those little tendencies that happen with just our day-to-day lives, trying to improve upon any of those malalignments and weaknesses that might be going on. All right, let's pause in the center. Let's lift the chest. Stabilize yourself with your hands. Twist and then sweep down around and back up to center. Do a little rock at the top and then swing and twist the other way. Getting as much range as feels comfortable for your body. You're really feeling that nice stability and mobility. Spine with the twist and then the full range swing. This is one of my favorite Qigong exercises. It's great when you integrate the breath with it. You exhale down, inhale up. One more each way. Back to side, and let's swivel the hips, lift the toe, bring it into the hammy. Little side to side. You can take it deeper if you want, but only if it feels good on the knees. Oh yeah. And then engage the core, snake the body up, step back and across. And then step back and twist. Float it across. Oh yeah, it's nice to feel that gliding motion. Let's come into our quarter squat. Do a little cat-cow, rounding the back, opening up as much range as you can. Really tilting that pelvis, chin to chest, opening up. Whatever range your body gives you. Now round out, engage that core, slow roll yourself up, stacking the vertebrae up over your hips. Swing the arms across the front, little crisscross. and then exit out. Oh yeah. Now swing the arms down and let's bounce in our squat. So when we're doing this, the goal is to not let the knees shift forward and our heels lift at all. We want to keep our heels down. We want to load right here, right where the hamstring meet the butt. And just do some nice air squats. Yeah. Keeping that core strong. And then let's take it wide. Keep those air squats going. You're always trying to sit into your derriere. So sit back into it. Up to counterbalance with your upper body, but keep your posture, even though you're leaning forward, counterbalancing. Good, let's bring the feet together and then rock the hips side to side, counter with your arms, like you're mogul skiing. I'm gonna pretend doing that. It's winter is coming. Yeah. Push those knees together. Feel the inner thighs. And then feel that outside stretch. If you're tight out here, it might feel a little sensitive as you push out. That's okay. Just find that range that feels good. Work that stability on the outside. Good. Now let's go into single leg squats. We're going to start here. Just doing a small range, feeling into it. Still sitting back into that glute. Then as you feel comfortable, you can take it deeper. Maintain your balance. And if you want, you can go all the way deep as you can. Just bring the arms down and up. Still trying to maintain that good, that integrity with the posture and the form. Oh yeah. Got your little other leg out there as a kickstand if you get a little off balance. Get three more of those. Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Other leg. Start with it nice and slow and easy. Feel into your balance. Find that sweet spot. Where you're really sitting into the glute. Keep your hips level. Don't open up the hips. Keep them square to the front. Good posture. Then once you really find all that, it's feeling good. If you want, you can take it deeper. Just really working on that strength and stability on the single leg. So good. Get three more. 12. This is my weak ankle. That's all right. We're working it. Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Check it out. Now we're going to do a little bit of power moves. So we're going to work on a little mini jumps. Not comfortable with it, just go up on your toes, all right? So we'll start with that. You're gonna go up on your toes and then land like you just landed from a jump. And you're trying to land in the same form that you were doing your gray squats. So you, boom, you land and absorb. But you go, whenever you jump, you always land ball to heel, absorbing down. So then you're gonna try a little mini jump where you just get off like a millimeter. You're almost not even jumping. You're trying to absorb and land. And then from there, if you want, you can start getting to maybe a centimeter or an inch or whatever. Just as long as it feels good on your back and on your knees. Don't do it any harder. Like you want to be able to feel like you're in full control. It's all in the muscles and there's no pain for the rest, for any of the joints. So let's do that. I'm going to do 10 here. You just do what you can. You need to skip and go into regular air squats. Do that. Otherwise, practice on that soft landing, absorbing, low impact. Halfway. Getting ready for my volleyball. Two more. Last one. All right, now we're warmed up, right? Shake those legs out. Let's go down to the mat, work some core, shall we? Let's start with a little bridging. I love to stabilize the back first before I do any of that stuff. So let's rock, arch, flatten, roll it up, pause at the top, roll it back down, nice and smooth. Pause at the top, feel into it, readjust everything so everything's in line. It feels strong. Feel your glutes, your quads, your hamstrings, even your erector spinae along your spine. Now let's hold it at the top. Let's go a little side to side. And then a little rocking of the hips. And then back to center, hold it, interlace your fingers together if you can. Either way, bring your shoulder blades together, really open up that posture in the chest, come up on the balls of your feet, and hold as high as you can. Feels comfortable for your back. Rock the hips side to side. Nice and smooth. And then rock the hips. Oh yeah. Release the arms, swing them overhead, slowly one vertebra at a time, bring the spine down. Oh yeah. Bring the knees into the hands, rock side to side. And then let's bring our forehead towards our knee. Extend one leg out, one knee in. We're rounding out, bringing in as much as we can, and then switching legs. Alternating sides. This feels too intense. You can be down here, just doing it this way. Make sure you bring the other leg all the way in before you move the other leg out, so you can hold that integrity here. Again, you should keep the resistance here, shouldn't go into your lower back. If it does, you got to pause, rock it out. This is a great one to work for strength in the neck, actually. So if that gets tired, relax it down. And then when the pain goes away, join back in, because you do want to have some strength in your neck. You just don't want to stress the neck out. Oh, yeah. If you want, you can straighten your legs up to make it a little more challenging and work that flexibility in the hamstring as you come up. Holding the integrity through the whole complex. If you notice, I'm keeping my shoulder blades off the ground. If you can't quite do that, that's okay. Just work with what your body gives you. And that neck might start getting tired. You can be down here. Again, always make sure you have the transfer before you lower the leg if it feels like it's too much for the abs. Oh yeah. Good, now pull your feet in. Grab wherever you can in here. You grab underneath here, here, and then hold. Rock around with it. And then what you're going to do is release, extend the legs out, arms come overhead, whatever you can, and then bring it back in. Stretch and then reach, stabilize. It's got to stay in strong. Nice and smooth. get three more of those. Again, if this is too much, go back to any. You can just do reverse crunches. Whatever your body feels like it can handle. Last one. Good, bring the knees in, relax the head down, rock side to side. Oh yeah. Beautiful. Now we're gonna roll over onto our bellies. Actually, and let's go into child's pose for a moment and just relax, stretch out that back. Release the knees. Do a little yoga. Reach those arms out. So when you're here, those areas that we're stretching is those lats, the lower back, the knees, the ankles. Focus there and find where your tightness is. Settle into that. Get a sweet stretch, not overstretch, just a nice feel good stretch. Then we're gonna switch. Shift forward into upward facing dog. If this is too much, you come down here. It's all about how your back feels in this one, or your wrists. So you can be up here, great. And what we're trying to do here is engage the core to protect the back. And then we're trying to drop the hips towards the mat, bend the elbows a little bit so we're working those arms, but we want to keep our shoulders from coming up here. We want to bring them down in a way, open that chest. And we're opening up the whole underneath side of the body from the hip flexors through the chests. Then we're gonna kick the hips up, turn the toes under, take a pause here for a moment to stretch the toes and the arches, and then kick up into down dog. We're gonna pedal the feet a little bit, get into that deeper stretch for the calves and the hamstrings. Really push through your hands. You shift your hips back. Get that nice straight line between your hands, shoulders, and hips. And then you're trying to drop your heels down. Now we're gonna do, and you want, so whatever foot is further away from your computer, you're gonna lift that one up in the air, bend the knee, and then open the hip. But keep this bottom leg, the knee, facing towards your upper body. You get a little hip opener here and a single leg stabilizer. It's really nice. And then you step that foot forward. You might have to swing it around, bring it forward, and just readjust into a lunge here. You want actually a little space between your back foot and front foot to create more lateral stability. So basically, they're each coming straight out from their hip. And then you're gonna center yourself, slowly bring yourself up to balance in a lunge, with the back heel up. Now I want this knee over the ankle. I want the back leg straight if I can, and this kind of dropped in. If it's too intense, shorten your distance. You can come up here, okay? Now, engage that core, open up. And even just right here, I feel a nice little stretch for my hip flexor. And then what we're gonna do is bring the arms up and then turn our gaze up the ceiling and open up whatever we can to get that nice stretch all the way through this frontal chain, all the fascia that runs underneath the skin and covers our muscles. They're the initiators of action. Want them to feel elastic and open. Now bring the arms down, drop your back heel, and then turn to the side into what's called warrior two. So we're keeping this knee right over the ankle. You don't want that knee to fall in or come back here. Keep it right over. And then our back heel is dropped back a little bit further than the toes, so there's a little bit of an angle there. We feel this nice opening and stretch for the hips. We're here, nice, balanced with that upper body. And then we're gonna turn that front palm up and then just rock, come into crescent pose. So we're making like a crescent moon. You can turn your gaze up to your palm Just feel that stretch and opening on this front side. What will happen is this knee will start coming away. Try to stay in your lunge. Keep working stability in those legs. Oh yeah. And then reach up and cartwheel forward. And you're going to straighten that front leg. Start sliding your hand down. Whatever depth you can hold integrity. If you need a little support, you can put a little even weight in your hand. You want the more of the challenge in the core, you open that hand up forward. Make sure you really open the top shoulder up and you're trying to create this nice stacking between your hands and shoulders. Then we're gonna bend that front knee, bring the hand down. You can either be here or you can take it deeper, come all the way down. Any position in here that feels right for your body. Keep opening. We're getting that nice twist and opening in the spine. This is so good for the hips and the spine. And then we're gonna bring that top hand down to the mat. And we're gonna little toe to heel walk that foot out to create a little more space in the front. And then rock that knee open to create the space. And then drop into this deep hip opener here. However deep you can go. You don't have to go all the way down. Just whatever feels right. If this is too intense, bring that back knee down. That'll help. And you're just trying to hold integrity the best you can with your posture. Working into anywhere it feels tight. Breathing into it. Use your breath, your exhale especially, to breathe into wherever it feels intense or tight. Come back up onto the hands. And then we're going to try what's called a side prayer. And what you're going to do is, first off, come here. If this feels challenging enough, just bring that outside hand here. And now we're opening up to the outside. If you want a little bit more of a challenge, you can go into side prayer, which is bringing that bottom forearm, or sorry, tricep onto the thigh, making a little prayer, and then opening up that elbow so you get that extra balance. Spinal rotation here. Oh yeah. Bring that hand back down, knee down, straighten out the toes. You stretch the back ankle, shift back. Get that nice hamstring stretch here. Now, if you want, you can rock it back too, all the way into a single leg child's pose, but only if it feels okay on the knee. Otherwise, stay right up here. Then we're gonna shift forward. So with the arm that's on the same side as this front leg, I'm gonna reach back, grab my foot, and then open up and get that nice spinal twist opener. You can't get that, that's okay. That feels too much. You're just gonna have your hands here, shift forward, and you're just stretching and opening this hip flexor here. Oh yeah. Love that one. All right, now we're gonna shift way back, bring this front foot across the mat, and then bring our hands in front into pigeon pose. So with pigeon pose, there shouldn't be pain in your knee or anywhere else. It's usually the knee. A lot of times it's because people try to kick this, the traditional ways to have this foot kicked way forward. That actually puts a lot of stress on the hip joint and it almost creates hypermobility in the hip, which is the last thing you want. So it's actually a little bit better. Your goal is to just feel it in your glute here, those deep muscles, the piriformis and gluteus medius and minimus. So I think the most ideal for your knee and your hip is to have this heel right underneath your opposite hip flexor. And let's start there. And I want you to start up high. And this is a great way to practice. If you're having a hard time with your lower back and stability when you're doing upward facing dog and you need to be on your forearms, this is a great way to practice it with your arms up. This is less stress on the wrist because your hips actually helping hold you up. So it's less pressure here. So you can work on your wrist strength here. And it also keeps you from sagging too far in to where your hips are down to the mat. So you can get that, you can hold integrity with the core and the lower back and not be in such extension. And you get that nice hip flexor stretch here. So let's start up high, good posture, open up. And we kind of figure out what those little adjustments are so we really feel like we're hit our sweet spot position. Nice opener on the underneath side. And then we just relax into it, to the forearms. You can come as deep as you feel comfortable, getting to that deep hip stretch. This is a lot of people with hip issues' favorite exercise. Or favorite stretch, I should say. Although it's not the most comfortable stretch in the world for most people. Gonna go for another 30 seconds. And come back up on your hands. Lift your hips, you can bring that leg back underneath you and push back to child's pose. And you might have to rock to the side to get yourself into this position. It doesn't matter, you don't have to transition perfectly. Just do with what works for your body. Just reach it out and let's actually come up on our hands and knees, walk in a circle. This is gonna make it easier for you to watch and for you to see what I'm doing by changing your other direction. So when we have our other leg forward, you can see everything well. So stretch, and then let's shift into upward facing dog. And even if you normally don't do this, I want you to at least be here. Your hand, you're using your hands, you're putting pressure into your hands, engaging that core, and you're trying to open up into upward facing dog, whatever height you can do. Good posture. And then lift the hips up by engaging the core. Turn your toes under. Kick back into down dog. Shuffle those feet. Drop the heels to the mat. Take it deeper. You should feel like you have a little bit more mobility for this, actually, this go around. Then let's lift that outside leg up. Bend the knee. Open the hips. Keep everything facing towards upper body, that knee shouldn't turn or torque on that bottom leg. And then bring that foot forward into the lunge. Find your balance, your good position, and then bring yourself up. Readjust, knee over the ankle, back leg straight. Good core engagement, the arms come up. Open up and then take your gaze along the ceiling to whatever distance you can do where you have the perfect stretch and challenge with your balance. You can hold a nice solid position. Arms down, heel, back heel down. Let's come into warrior two. That back heel's a little further back. Knees over the ankle, hips open, nice and solid. Let's reverse it into crescent. Keep breathing into the exercise. If you get a little off balance, it's okay. Just refine the position. Find a position that works for your body. And then swing those arms in a cartwheel motion, straighten that front leg, slide it down. Again, just go as deep as feels comfortable. Then feel the back and spine rotating. Open yourself up, channeling right up to the sky. Bend the knee, drop the hands down. And you can be here if that feels too deep. Always make it easier for yourself. You want to feel like you feel good in these poses. Don't force the deeper poses or the harder positions. Get kind of master the easier ones before you go into a little harder range. Bring that top hand down, kick the back heel up, walk the out front foot outside, rock the knee out a little bit, drop in to that deep hip opener. It's too intense, bring that back knee down. Bring yourself back up on your hands. Walk that outside hand close in and rotate and open up the opposite side. Facing back away from your computer. And if you want to try the more challenging one, you can bring that bottom hand in, that tricep on the thigh, make your prayer pose, and then rotate, twist. Really feels like you're wringing out the spine on this one. It's real strong and intense in the glutes and just with balance. Bring both hands down, bring the back knee down, straighten the toes out, rock back so you straighten that leg, get into a hamstring stretch. You can just stay right here, or if you want to go deep, you can, only if it feels okay, on your knee. The amazing thing is that over time, a lot of times you can get to these harder ones if you just stay consistent, listening and not overdoing it in the beginning. It took me a long time to get to be able to do this kind of a position for my knees and my ankle, but now I'm able to do it. But it's even taken a year or more just to get to where I could do a full child's pose because I was so tight. Shift forward, come here and stretch, or you can reach back, grab that foot and open up. The opposite hand of the leg you're stretching here. Release it. Rock back. Bring that foot towards you and across the mat. Bring your hands in front. You might need to rock to the side first in order to get to that position, though. Whatever works for you. And start up high. So we're in pigeon pose, but high. That heel is right underneath the opposite hip. Oh, you're adjusting to make sure there's no pain in the knee. Everything feels good and in line. As you move around, you can settle in a little deeper and then really open up for a moment. Try to get as much extension as you can, keeping that core strong. And let's take it down as deep as feels comfortable. Really try to get into that glute back here. If you have to rock your hips to the side to really feel it, that's a nice way to get into it a little deeper. Thirty seconds. Bring yourself up. Lift the hips up so you can bring your knees underneath you and go into free motion cat-cow. Moving, rotating through the head, neck, shoulders, spine, and hips. Turn your toes under. Rock back to whatever squat feels good. If you're up here, you have your forearm down and then raise your arm up. If you're down low, hand down, hand up. Spiral that wrist, reach it up. Keep opening, always opening with the back, not forcing it with the arm. Other side. Hands down, hips up, sway it side to side. If you need to support your back, grab your legs. Otherwise, just hang. Oh, yeah. Hands above the knees, straighten the arms, come into flat back. Really try to lengthen strong. And then sit into your heels so you can raise your arms into chair pose. And then drive with the hips, lead with the heart, bring it up strong. Let the arms fall to the outside. Bring the arms forward. Dive the fingers down through the center line. Pause here. Inhale, bring it to the backside. Exhale down the backside. Inhale up the inside. Exhale, float the hands. Inhale, bring in the chi. Exhale, float the hands down. Settle into the lower dantian for a moment. Take a pause, feel into your body. Feel how much more amazing it feels this morning. Y'all have a beautiful holiday weekend. Let's take some of that sweet energy into our hands, share it up with each other, wherever we're at. Here we go. Namaste. Thanks for coming.